Today, we are taking a look at a new elevator, a new way to move quickly up in the world. These are bubble columns. You know them. You've seen them before. You put some soul sand and some water down, and then you can move up to the top. But these bubble columns be invisible. They're invisible bubble columns. It's a crazy glitch that makes it work. Big thank you to the YouTube members out there. You guys support the channel directly. You guys rock. If you want to find out more, click the join button. And of course, if you can't become a member, subscribing is always awesome. So here we are inside of Minecraft, and these are just a few examples of bubble columns that are invisible bubble columns. You can still see the bubble from the animation of the bubble column, but the water itself is actually missing. There is no water. So you can sort of like move through it nice and easy. Of course, it still has the bubble column effect of sending you into the air very, very fast. These are small examples of what this could be, but you could really go up 100 blocks, 200 blocks, build limit, whatever you want. Obviously, this is an overworld or end thing. You can't really have water in the nether, so that's not possible. So I have three different designs here, but really your imagination is the limit when it comes to adding extra bits onto it. There are some limitations, which I'll get to when we start building. First off is a glass sort of contraption where you use glass blocks. You can step inside of here. It'll send you up to the top. Then when you're up at the top, you would just jump onto this block, or probably this would be a different level of a house, something like that. And we just use signs to keep the water at bay from coming out. There's a few different ways to break this. One of which, the biggest one, is to update any of the columns. So anything where there would be water, if you accidentally update a block next to it, update just means change. If you change a block right next to it, it might break. Now there is a way just to quickly swap out a block and then it won't break. So basically, if there's any air next to this water, it'll start to realize, oh, this is a weird glitch, and it'll start to break. So you got to make sure that there is no air directly next to the water blocks. Doesn't matter about the diagonal blocks. Like this block right here doesn't actually matter. I just have it there for looks because I need something for these signs to attach to. So that's just there for looks. Here is a different design. This one uses fence gates to sort of have an entrance to, and then it uses glass panes. And because it's only one, a little bitty glass pane, look at him, he's so small, then it's really thin. If I put down another one, you can see that the glass pane starts to get bigger. And so you can enter just here from the open gates here, and then you're sent up to the top, just like with the one before. Now, you'll notice that because there's nothing diagonal to these glass panes, you can just move directly through the entire contraption here. So this next one that I built, it's a little bit different because technically it's one block taller. You can see how the bubbles go a little bit taller than the others. I use some slabs on the top, and there is no entrance. This is really, you could enter from any side. I'm not using anything to sort of be able to pass through like the signs or with the fence gates. And by the way, here, I'll stop being in creative mode for a moment. You just walk right into it, go up. This one has a little bit of a lip, but once you get up to the top, you can easily just walk right out. This one has these slabs right here. I found that sometimes it's a little bit difficult to sort of dismount off of the top of the bubbles. And so having just a half slab makes it a little bit easier just to walk right out of the bubbles, I found. There we go. I will show you how to make each one of these. Really, I'll just show you how to make the basic design, and you'll be able to use your imagination to come up with your own. So what is required for this build? Well, like I mentioned, if any air shows up next to this glitched bubble column, and we'll just break this to kind of show you, everything above will break. And we still have a little bit of bubble column in this one block down here, but there and up, that is no longer possible to go up into the sky. So that's a big bummer. So you need to make sure that you use a block of some type on every corner. And so let's say that this is your water source. You need it to be not on every corner, I guess I should say, every face the diagonals do not matter. So you need to make sure that where the glass is in this scenario, that you have some type of block. Now you can get creative with whatever block that is. Like I have used iron bars, used some glass pane. So if you wanted to use any block, terracotta, stone, whatever, doesn't matter. You just need to make sure that that is not air right there. So you need to have enough blocks for whatever the edges are going to be. Then you need to make sure to have at least one soul sand, at least one bucket of water. And however tall you want this to be, you need that many dispensers and empty buckets. That's right. Dispensers and empty buckets are a big sort of thing that you need for this build. You'll need eventually some blocks of redstone and some pistons. In this scenario, let's go ahead and build the first thing with just solid blocks of glass, just so that you can sort of get an idea. What we would start off with is just roughing out sort of where we want this to be. So we want it to be right here. We're gonna have an entrance. So I'm gonna just make an entrance with just a few blocks of glass right here. Then we're going to have the actual column. So we're gonna go up just a few blocks because we're gonna build all this live. So we don't wanna go too crazy with how high this is gonna be, just so that we don't use up too much time. And we wanna make sure that all of the block faces are sort of used. By the way, if you're building this yourself, don't build yet. Just watch and then build in a moment. Then we're gonna take some soul sand, we're gonna put it down, and then we're gonna go up to the top and put down water. But before we do that, because we don't want this to go everywhere, I'm gonna look for my signs, which are over here. And we're going to add signs so that we don't have an overflow of water. Oops, didn't mean to type that. And then we're gonna add our water to the top. By the way, in Java Edition, which I normally play on, if you were to place water right there, the rest of the water would not create a like source blocks. And in this version, it does, which is like super crazy. So you put one block up there and then it creates source blocks all the way down, which is pretty nice and easy for us. So now we have a normal bubble column. Now, the reason I told you not to go ahead and start your build is because what we actually need to do is break out this back wall and replace it with dispensers. Now, I'm using this fancy little way that I already have an empty bucket inside of this dispenser, but what you would be doing is taking a normal dispenser, so let me just grab this one here, and then placing an empty bucket inside of it. So I guess we'll do it that way. So we're gonna, be in creative mode so we don't accidentally fly up. Put down a dispenser, make sure that it is facing towards the soul sand, and I'm having a hard time doing that, so face it that way, and then put an empty bucket inside. Then do that for the rest, and if you were building this for the first time, obviously I'd suggest doing this before you put in that back wall, so you don't have to break glass or anything. So I've gone ahead and done that, so now I have this back wall of dispensers with empty buckets inside. Now, the next step is to activate the dispensers and just suck the water out from in front of the dispenser. You don't need to go in a certain direction, so I'll actually kind of start here from the bottom, which makes it look kind of interesting, because if I was to break these, you can see that there's still water there, but then as we go from the top, once we suck up out all the water, you can see that it dries out and we still have that bubble column, but we have the dispensers there and no water, obviously. So now we need to get rid of the dispensers, but we have a problem, and that is that if there is ever air next to this glitched out bubble column, it'll all break. We don't want that to happen. So what we're gonna do is we're going to use a piston to push this dispenser out of the way and then replace it with another block. So whatever you want the block to be that it is replaced, and here we're just using glass, just set it next to the dispenser. So we're just gonna go up here with the glass. Next, I like to use my redstone blocks to put down a line of redstone here, and I'm having a real hard time building. Then you take a piston, place it on the redstone, and then it'll push it out of the way. Now this is kind of piston and redstone heavy, so you can do this individually. You don't have to do this all at the same time like I'm doing. So if you don't have many pistons or you don't have this much redstone, just place down a piston, fire it so it pushes it out of the way, and then move on. And then we can just get rid of this, and we can get rid of this, and we can also get rid of all of our dispensers. The buckets will fall out of them once you are finished. And let's just replace this. And so now we have our bubble column elevator with the water missing. We just walk inside and it will work just as we expected. So to reiterate, build your walls except for the back wall. Then put down your dispensers with an empty bucket inside. Fire those dispensers off, which will suck up the water, leaving a bubble column glitch. Then you use pistons to replace the block without ever having any air next to the bubble column, and then you can destroy all of the stuff around it in order to actually use it and make it look good. These blocks can obviously be replaced with any type of paint or anything else. I feel like if you were to have this in your world in a house, it would be so impressive. People would not realize what the heck is going on. It is just so, so neat. And by the way, if anyone's been wondering, yes, this, it doesn't matter that I'm in creative. So let's just switch our game mode to survival and we can walk in here just like this. What's funny is you don't even get the water effect. You don't even get like the fact that you're in water and that you need bubbles. And that could be just because it's a bubble column, because you get air immediately from your bubble column, which is really, really cool. So this is all working great. This one's broken from before. All of these seem really stable. Anytime that I save and quit and then jump back into this world, by the way, I'm in the beta. So this works on the current version, which I believe is 1.13. 1.13, I think, is the current version, but I'm running 1.15. So even in the beta, it is still working. And as you can see from just saving and quitting, that it doesn't matter. The world reload doesn't affect this glitch. Thanks so much for watching this episode of OMG Craft. If you liked it, please give this video a big old thumbs up. Also, make sure you subscribe for future videos, tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights here on OMG Craft. You guys are incredible. Thank you so much to those of you who subscribe, and we will see you in the next video. Bye.